Hey, this is Carlos Cavallo. Welcome back. You know, a lot of women experience the mind games that men play when they're dating or they're in a relationship. Now, I definitely don't condone game playing. Be clear about that. But you do need to know when somebody's manipulating you. So today we're talking about 9 mind games men play and how to beat them. And of course, before we get started, big 3 time, make sure you like and subscribe to the video. Make sure you turn on notifications so you know when my next one comes out. And of course, leave me your questions and comments below. I check those out every week. Now, I've got a shocking truth for you about the mind games that men play, but I'm gonna wait for a little bit and reveal that in a little while. For right now, let's dig right into those 9 mind games that men play and how to recognize them. Starting with number 1 mind game is the hopeful game. So you go out and you meet a guy and things seem pretty good between you. He even texts you right afterwards to tell you, hey, it was great to meet you, looking forward to seeing you soon. That sounds hopeful, right? I mean, he put in the effort there to text you, maybe adds a little bit of sweetness in there and promises a follow-up. But it doesn't happen, right? A week or two after you reply to his text with your own, hey, it was great to meet you, you realize he hasn't texted you back yet. That date has yet to happen. Now, there's a ton of things that could have happened in that time, right? His dog could have died, his mom might have gotten sick, he got busy at work, he ran a full marathon in the Swiss Alps. In fact, you might have heard a few of those excuses from him if you happened to run into him at the grocery store or the Starbucks when he was caught off guard. But you also know they're usually not true most of the time. The reality is that he either lost interest in you or he met someone else, neither of which is necessarily your fault. Now let me explain. Guys have something that is called the shiny toy syndrome. Women have this too, meaning that whatever prospect is currently on the front of his mind or her mind, that's who we're focused on, right? That's usually the woman for him that has triggered his interest the most recently. Now I'm going to come back and talk about this specific shiny toy thing in a minute, but a lot of women misinterpret and think that the woman who has slept with him most recently is the one that wins him. That can happen, but it's not why he didn't call you or text you back. The reason he ghosted you is simply because he didn't have you right there in front of him to remind him why he should be chasing you down. You gotta stay on the top of somebody's mind. After the spirit of the moment passes, sometimes we forget just how much we were into somebody. Don't get too attached to his words or even his empty promises. Nothing is real until it happens, okay? Don't let yourself get caught up in a fantasy future, as I like to say. And you gotta stay shiny to him or he just might lose his interest. Again, I'll talk to you about how that mind game works in a minute. Okay, games men play number 2, the coincidence game. This is one that a lot of guys play, and that's because it helps him move forward with you. You ever have a guy that told you, wow, we are so alike, where he's pointing out all the similarities between you and him every chance he gets? Or maybe you two discover a coincidence in your lives, like his mom and your mom went to the same school. You might even think, there's no way that can be a mind game, right? You can't go back in time and make that kind of coincidence happen. Well, the truth is that we all have things in common. Every person has something in common with somebody else. Some people have more things in common and they're easier to see. What a guy likes to do is to find and point out those things in his life that match your life. He wants you to see, we're alike. You should sleep with me. For example, you're telling him about how you went skiing last weekend, and in response, he'll tell you that, oh, he loves skiing. Oh my gosh. Now he pounces on that because he wants your approval and he wants you interested in him. And then you find out a few months later in conversation that he actually used to snowboard back when he was 17 and lived in Vermont. Yeah, like 20 years ago. Now, technically, he wasn't lying, but it's a little bit of a stretch for him to be so enthusiastic about this little coinkydink that you both like skiing, right? Well, what you have to do is make sure you call a guy on his malarkey. Does anybody say malarkey anymore? I don't know. Be sure to throw him a little curveball every so often to put him on the spot. But you gotta do it gently. So using the skiing example, what you have to do is ask him a question about it. Don't just let it sit there and be like, oh wow, you like it too? You gotta say something like, oh yeah, I really enjoy getting up to the mountains as much as I can during the season. What equipment do you use? And that's when he'll start to stumble. He'll be like, I haven't bought new gear in a long time. I like Berman quite a bit. You mean Burton? Now, of course, don't call him quite like that, but calling him on it isn't to expose him for his exaggeration. It's simply to fact check how he's representing himself. You gotta know what's real about him. Trust me, you wanna find out earlier rather than later if he is who he's presenting himself to be. A little exaggeration is fine. On the other hand, a lot of exaggeration is a really big deception. Games men play number 3, the meant to be game. Now this game is simply a man's method of getting into bed with you. Pure and simple. It's not an evil game, but it is one that you have to watch out for if you want to basically pace your relationship for the best chance of succeeding. Now, it's not a secret, at least it better not be, that guys are in more of a rush to get you into bed than you are to do the same. And if that's all you want, well, then go ahead, be my guest. Well, I mean, be his guest, go for it. But if you want a relationship to last, you have to take a little time to build up some anticipation and desire with him. Now, I'm very clear with my clients that men generally don't walk away from women that they've had a chance to bond with. It's really critical. If there's a connection, he's not going to want to walk away from it. And he'll want to work on the relationship. He'll actually put in the sweat equity that will make it last. Which is why you have to see through his attempts to rush you into bed and be willing to compassionately hold him off a little bit. There's no rush. If you're planning on staying with this guy for a while, you can make up all that lost time of whoopee later on. So when he starts in with this dreamy love talk about destiny, love, you two were meant to be together, well, he's basically leading you to the bedroom. You need to be prepared to hit the brakes. Games men play number 4, the self-esteem game. Now this one is typically only seen with guys who are really well versed in relationship psychology. What he does is he lightly pings your self-esteem by subtly, or not so subtly, giving you a slight insult. For example, you're out doing some shopping with him and you basically look at some clothes, you try on a dress, and you ask him how it looks. And what does he say to you? He says, "Oh, well, that's not a good color on you. Stings, huh?" But that's how he works his magic. He knows that these little negs can give you, well, basically leave you feeling a little compromised. Negs are compliments that leave you feeling very uncomplimented or even slightly insulted. Now, this came from a book back a few years ago called The Game. And the idea behind the neg is that it's a light insult that lowers the woman's self-esteem and value and makes her want to earn his approval again. Now, I know you're saying, "Dude, that would never work on me," but the unfortunate thing is there are actually a lot of women that this does work on, and men too. But it's a sly way to manipulate somebody, and it's not good to use. It's sometimes difficult to spot unless you have a trained ear, and you know when a guy is playing this game. To be fair, most men aren't this conscious about this sort of thing, so it's more likely he's more insensitive than trying to dupe you. Lowering your self-esteem or playing with your self-image is a very dangerous place to start a relationship. Don't let his attempts, whether they're conscious or unconscious, do this. Don't let him slip by you. Now, this is also a warning sign of a relationship that can also not just turn sour, but even get abusive. If you notice this happening more than once, you gotta call him out on it. You could say something like, "Hey, I realize you're probably joking, but I noticed that you use that kind of put down a couple times. That kind of concerns me." You only need to point out that you noticed it. If he's aware of his actions, he now knows you're on to him. And if he wasn't aware of it, it'll be a little bit of a wake-up call for him to clean up his act. Games men play the flatter game. This one is sometimes called the buttering up game, where he compliments and flatters you to no end. Some guys know how vulnerable women are to flattery and they lay it on thick. He'll even sound poetic in the process. "You are so beautiful, I just want to drink you in with my eyes." Some guys flatter incessantly just because he really is taken in with you. This is very common. This is a bit of a concern because he could also be feeling inadequate and unworthy of you. And one thing you must avoid is a guy who has low self-worth or is always putting himself one down on the ladder. These guys will eventually self-destruct in your relationship and they'll take you along for most of the ride. Don't date low-quality men. They will always pull you down to their level of mediocrity. All right, games men play the moody guy game. This is an important game to explain because you might get really caught up in his roller coaster emotional states. This is a guy that goes from being really positive and upbeat on your first couple of dates to being weird and distant later on. Sometimes he goes back to being carefree and happy, only to take another turn toward being distant. There are generally two possibilities here. Number one, he's really bipolar and has a manic depressive cycle in his behavior. This is something he should reveal to you if you get closer, and at the very least, he should either have medication or a process for managing his mood cycles so they don't impact you or your relationship. Or number two, he's just dealing with his own emotional confusion. You see, many women think that all men are running around totally afraid of their emotions. This is pretty much how every single magazine and book out there explains away the differences between men and women. And it's just not true. Some men are, but most men are not. This really isn't a fair way to view a man's response to an intimate relationship. The fact is that a man needs time away from a relationship in order to feel like a man again, and then he's ready to re-engage. And that's why these guys tend to seem like they're moody and distant from you. He's trying to take care of his own needs, to be a man, to be separate for a little while, and not run away completely from you. It's a difficult balance for a guy, and it's not something that many women can relate to. Now, for the first kind of guy who might actually be bipolar, that's a very serious situation, and you should know about that up front. Games men play, number 7, the pay-to-lay game. This one is, unfortunately, a real game, but it's one that you've probably been aware of for years. This is where a guy buys you dinner, buys you drinks, and generally acts like your sugar daddy just so that he can hold it over your head at the end of the night so he can get some sex, or a handy, or, well, you know, you get the picture, right? The point is there should not be any kind of transactions like this in your relationship, especially ones that are not even connected, like sexual favors to trade for a nice evening out on the town. The unfortunate part of this mind game that men play is that it just makes women want to pay their own way to avoid that kind of obligation with him. And who could blame you for that, right? But what it also does is it makes the good guys that are out there, about 80 to 90% of the guys, by the way, feel like they can't be the man in the relationship when she won't let him provide for her in a traditional way. He wants to be chivalrous. Games men play, number 8, the Mr. Big game. Well, this isn't like he's trying to be Mr. Big from Sex and the City. This game is more about him trying to impress you, which kind of makes it a very natural and forgivable game. After all, you're probably trying to impress him just as much, aren't you? Well, still, it can be easy for him to go overboard with this game. Let me give you an example of one of the Mr. Big games, okay? The show-off game. Maybe he shows up in a flashy car that you suspect is not really his. Or maybe it is his, and that makes you concerned that he's trying to impress you with his money. Either way, guys will regularly show this kind of behavior when he's trying to boost his status in your eyes. Men instinctively know that they want to bring more to the table than just themselves, but they often misunderstand how to impress you in the right ways. And I've got a couple more of those smaller games, more along the lines of the Mr. Big games, on the article on the site. Games men play, number 9, the Are You Still Shiny game. Human beings have a certain trait in common. We all love shiny new things. In fact, the word new is one of the most effective words in advertising. We all want the thrill of something new coming into our samey, ho-hum lives. And we all love that feeling of a new romance the most. Just awesome. Think of all the reasons that new love is so addictive and cool. It's a chance to start again with a new hopeful. There's a thrill of being revalidated by somebody new, the excitement of new love, the adrenaline rush of lusty new sex. There's just a ton of reasons why we love it. And for many men and women, we're addicted to the newness. The thought of that thrill eventually going away is too much to bear. They need to know their partner is still shiny and new to them, at least in a few ways. So we're all scared to death of becoming bored with our partners. So you'll sense this from him from time to time, but it's not just him wondering if you're still shiny to him. He's actually more worried that he isn't as shiny to you, that he's lost his appeal to you. And it's important to not misunderstand what men are thinking and feeling when they're dating you. It's easy to look at his actions and think that he's purposely playing mind games with you. Okay, here's the big truth I've been waiting to tell you. The truth is much more incredible. The big secret is, men don't play head games. I should say that men don't play mind games intentionally. We don't. Men simply don't engage in that kind of manipulative behavior. We don't do it on purpose. What you're seeing is his natural reaction to the emotions inside him that are triggered by you. Every game you think you see is typically what happens when he doesn't know what he's going to do next. That's right, especially when he does nothing. So how do you win these mind games that men play in relationships, especially if he doesn't show or even know that he's playing them? It seems that you've got a pretty big challenge. Well, that's why you need to have the best information on guys and how to get past his obstacles. You need to know what to say to him to get him to respond to you and stop the games before they start. The key is you got to know what he's thinking and what makes him feel safe enough with you to lower his guard and drop the games. That's why I pulled together, this little link below me. Go to this link and I'll tell you about all the exact words that men want to hear from a woman. They're called the passion phrases. It's what he needs to hear from you to fall in love with you. Go check them out. Again, you can get the additional information on the site. The article has a few more games you might want to check out at datingadviceguru.com. And do the big three. Make sure you like and subscribe to the video. Turn on your notifications so you know when the next one's coming out. And of course, leave me questions and comments below. I'll check them out. This is Carlos from datingadviceguru.com. As always, live and love with passion.